I know as human, we learn a lot through question and answers. If I don't understand something, what will make me to understand that particular topic or that particular subject better will be when I ask another person, or when I ask another person who is more experienced on that particular field. So on an episode like this, where we focus more on question and answers, you can gain a lot when another person's question is answered. It might not be your question directly, but you might gain a lot from that particular question. Hello everyone and welcome to the channel. My name is Ndema Zegolov, and on this channel we talk everything about trading, business, personal finance and tips to help you stay profitable as a forex trader. So if this is your first time coming to the channel, please hit that red subscribe button below to subscribe to the channel so that you can always be updated when we come up with awesome content like this. On today's video, we're just going to be going straight to the point. I'm going to be focusing on most of the questions on the question I received from Instagram, because I did like a poll on Instagram where I asked people to ask their questions, and I'll be giving them answers either business or forex related questions. So I did make a poll on Instagram. So I got almost about 200 questions. But today I'm just going to be picking like the top 15 or the top 20, or the video is just going to be like 10 minutes. So I'm just going to be picking like the most important questions that I know. I've seen many people asking those questions on my comment section over and over on a daily basis. So I'm just going to pick few of those questions and answer on today's episode. So let's start with the first question. This one is from, I think, Tammy. I'm not going to be calling the name. Let's just focus on the question. Then on the screen, I'll be putting the same question on the screen. So this Victor said, which broker are you using? Yes, I've mentioned Time Without Number on my video, that you might know how to trade forex, you might know how to do price analysis, you might know how to analyze the chart, you might know how to do everything in forex. But now, if you don't have the right tools, it's like being a farmer. You might know everything about agriculture, but if you don't have the right tools, there is no way you're going to make any produce. It's the same thing in trading. You might know everything about forex trading, but if you don't have the right tools, there is no way you're going to make money. And part of having the right tools is having the right broker. So the broker that I use on a daily basis, even on my live videos, live withdrawals and everything, no matter the amount you want to withdraw, there are ECN brokers, is IC Market. Alright, so I personally use IC Market on all my videos that I do share with you guys, and I've spoken a lot about brokers on my channel. If you are using a broker, check very well. There are two types of broker. You have what they call market makers and ECN broker. ECN stands for Electronic Communication Network. When you are looking for a broker, look for a broker which is an ECN broker, alright? Because an ECN broker wants you to win. An ECN broker wants you to make profit. Because when you launch a trade with an ECN broker, the only thing you pay is just a commission. They don't want a situation where they are not praying for you to lose. They are not praying for you to lose your trade. Because as opposed to market makers, when you actually have a loss in forex trading, that money goes to their pocket as their OTC gains. So market makers will pray that you should blow your account. Market makers will pray that you should blow that entire account you have, because when you blow that entire account, it goes to them as their OTC gains. So they make money through OTC gains, they make money through commissions, and they make money through spread. But for ECN brokers, the only way they make their money is through a commission, all right? So they have a commission that, so long as you place a trade, you pay them a small commission. That is the only thing they want. Which, if you are looking for a broker, make sure you look for an ECN broker. And as I stated earlier, IC Market is an ECN broker. Or if IC Market is not available in your country, they have a list of two other brokers that you can select from. So you can also check two other brokers, and the links are on this video description. So make sure you use the link on this video description so that you'll be signing up with the best broker. Then this person said, bro, how do you get entry signals in the market, and which trading zones do you prefer? Entry signals, there are many ways in forex trading. For you to start a trade and finish, you have trade execution and trade management. And coming to trade execution depends on the strategy. All right, it all depends on the strategy that you're using to trade. A strategy is just a series of rules. It's just a series of rules that tell you, okay, if this happens, if you see this happening, then you have to take this action. If you see this happening, then you have to take this action. That is just a strategy. All right, so each strategy has its own entry rules. So with this question, is strategy dependent. I can only give you a specific answer based on a particular strategy, all right? So let me just take something like a new trading strategy, because on my channel, I have a particular strategy which is going viral now. That strategy is going viral, which is known as the straddle strategy. It's used mostly for news trading. For that strategy, my entry point is just, I use only stops, buy stops and sell stops. So I wait for when I already put my entry point, buy stop and sell stops, I wait for the news to come out. And once the news come out, no matter the direction of the news, no matter any direction the news take, I will still make money, because those are my rules based on that particular strategy. All right, then this person says, do you do mentorship? Yes, of course. I won't be here if I don't do mentorship. The reason why I'm here is because I want to help another person. I want to impact another person's life. But now, since we're already above 10,000, going to 20,000, 50,000 and above, it is very difficult and humanly impossible for me to do mentorship one-on-one sessions with more than 10,000 people. So because of that, that is why you see on the channel, there is what they call channel membership that I can only do now, one-on-one mentorship with people who have selected that particular, who have gone under channel membership. You need to click that join button. Then you go under the perks, they call them the perks. Then you select the level that says mentorship. That is the only time I can be able to get to you one-on-one, because that tells me that, okay, these are the serious people that need mentorship. Then the next question I have here from Tim Nomi, or what is it? Yeah. They say, what is your opinion on trading for prop firms like FDMO, MyForex Fund, Trader Central, and all of that? Yes. There is nothing bad in trading with a prop firm, but try as fast as possible to go at to go. That means try within the at least as soon as possible, as soon as you are able to go private. That is the best advice I can give everyone. I started trading for a prop firm. If you watch the first video on my channel, I think the video, yeah, I'm going to leave a link this side or up here or somewhere. If you watch that first video, I did explain how I started. And when I started, I was trading with Apari Fund. So it was a prop firm. I think before I ended with them, I was trading with a $270,000 account. That is a prop firm. But when I traded with them and I was able to have my own funds, I moved immediately to open my own two private accounts. I had an account with IC Market and I had an account with another broker. So as soon as I started making consistent profits on those accounts, I quit trading with that prop firm. Why? Because when you are trading as a private trader, it gives you a lot of control. It gives you, trading sometimes has to do with your psychology. All right, it has to do with your psychology. So when you are trading with a prop firm, it's like somebody's imposing on your psychology. Somebody is telling you that, okay, if this doesn't happen, you need to do this. So they have their own risk mitigation in place, which if you're not too careful, it might even play around your psychology. So starting with a prop firm, yes, it's a nice thing, but try as fast as possible to go private if you have a way. All right, so try as much as possible to go private as soon as you have the funds. Then what is your take on investing in cryptocurrencies? Cryptocurrency now is one of the most, I will just come as plain as it is. It's one of the biggest industries now because of the technology, because of the blockchain technology. So because of the blockchain technology, most cryptocurrencies, the value they appreciate is more than, I think for the whole of last year, the appreciation value for cryptocurrencies is more than 200%. It's 200% greater than even the entire stock market. So the cryptocurrency industry is there to stay. It's there to stay because of the blockchain technology. But you need to be very, very careful. Cryptocurrency is not a scam. Blockchain is not a scam. But the people who introduce blockchain and all those things to you, if you are not careful, you might be scammed. If you are not careful, you then give a general term to say, okay, cryptocurrency is a fun, it's a scam, blockchain is a scam. No, in general, it's the same thing, just like forex trading itself is not a scam. But the people introduce you to forex, they can actually scam you. So be very careful when it comes to cryptocurrency, because that is the highest industry that has the highest numbers of scam. That is the highest industry. But if you are in cryptocurrency and you are careful, you know when to sign up for your account, you know where to pursue your knowledge, you know the strategies to use to trade in cryptocurrency, you make a fortune. All right, you make a fortune. You not only make a living, but you make a fortune from cryptocurrencies. So be very careful who you listen to, where you give your money to. That's why I even see sometimes on the comment section, I see a lot of impersonated accounts. Anytime I drop a video, people write under, contact me on WhatsApp, send me money. Let me invest on crypto for you. If you see any person asking you money to invest in crypto, or asking you money for an investment scheme where you send $500 and within 2 days they give you $20,000. Or $30,000, run away, because even the highest stock that appreciate doesn't appreciate for that particular value. If it's too good to be true, then it is not true. All right, if it's too good to be true, then it is not true and it is a scam. Be very, very careful. Cryptocurrency has come to stay. It's one of the biggest industries you can make a living. But if you're not careful, you lost a fortune in cryptocurrency. So what are the key things a strategy is made up of? Just like I said, there's a video. Oh, I think that video is the second video on my channel. The video, I think, is the SSROP strategy of profitable traders. SSRO, the first S stands for skills. The second S stands for strategy. YRO stands for risk management, and P stands for trading psychology. So under that particular system, I think you should watch that video. If you haven't watched that video, go on my channel and look for that video. I think it's called the SSRO quadrant of profitable forex trader. That quadrant it tells you everything about it. But if you want to be a profitable forex trader, you need to go through that particular quadrant. All right, so let's go to the next question. Let's go to the any advice for young people beginning in life and forex in general. Yes, the best advice, I also started at a very early age, although it was a very difficult curve for me, but the best advice I can give you is give yourself time to master the skills. Forex trading is not a get rich quick scheme. Although forex trading is a get rich sure scheme, but it is not a get rich quick scheme. All right, you're not gonna become a millionaire tomorrow. You're not gonna become a millionaire after a month. It's like becoming a surgeon. If I see somebody performing a surgery on someone, I can't just walk up to that person and say, okay, I see how you're doing this thing. I want to become like you. I want to start doing surgery tomorrow. I think maybe I'll start making money in the month. So it's the same thing with trading. You need to give yourself time to actually master the skills. That is the best advice I can give to anyone. If you see anyone preaching forex trading to you as a get rich quick scheme, or as network marketing, or as something you just join and within the next few months you start making money, my friend, no, you are going to a circle of dumb that will end up taking all your money. So you need to be very, very careful. Before you invest your hard-earned $1, before you invest your hard-earned money, give yourself first to learn the skill. Give yourself time to first of all master the skills before you can invest your money. Don't even if you find yourself asking trading or trading opinion. All right, if you find yourself asking a trading opinion from another person, then you shouldn't even be trading live. That is the best advice I can give you. If you find yourself asking another person where to put your stop loss, where to put your take profit, or where to put your entries, then you shouldn't even be trading forex, because I can see you heading to somewhere to a level where you'll be able to lose everything in your life. I've gone through that same circle where I lose everything I had, including even my house rent, in forex, because I saw forex trading as a get rich quick scheme. So please, if you are just starting in forex, make sure you filter the number of people you listen to, and then make sure you give yourself time to master the skills, and never give your money to any person to trade for you. That is why even on the people who contact, on the fake comments on my channel, people try to impersonate and say give money for them to trade. I will never take your money to say I want to trade for you. No, I trade, I have my own accounts that are enough for me. And on this channel, I teach people how to catch fish instead of giving them fish. So I'll prefer to teach you how to trade forex instead of giving you signals. All right, that is why I don't even focus on the signal aspect of trading, because I want to teach people how to trade forex. I want to impact another person's life. If I give you a signal today, then I have to live to give you signals for life. But if I teach you how to trade forex, then you'll be able to be self-sustainable for life. It's the same thing. If I give you fish today, then I need to give you fish for life. But now, if I teach you how to fish, then you're going to be able to fish for yourself for life. So let's go to the next question. It says, sir, is it advisable to use systems indicators even if it is just to identify market trend in forex? Yes. All right, Yes, although I'm totally against indicators. For me, coming to forex trading, indicators are lagging. All right, indicators are lagging. That is before you even see a particular response, before an indicator tells you to buy, or before an indicator tells you to get out of a trade. If you are somebody who knows the dynamic of trading, who knows demand and supply levels, buy pressure, selling pressure, all those things, if you are somebody who knows the dynamic of the market, you would have seen that particular signal ever since. All right, if you're somebody who knows price action, you would have seen that particular signal ever since. So before the indicator even tells you the market is going up, if you are somebody who knows what you are doing, you would have already used higher highs, higher lows, higher highs, higher lows, see that the market is already forming higher highs, higher lows. It's clear. That is a clear indication that the market is going up. If I put an indicator on that particular chart, and an indicator will just tell me, maybe a moving average will just tell me that the market is going up. But before it told me the market was going, I already saw it. Whether you're using RSI, the MACD, the fractal, the moving averages, exponential, I know all those things. I've studied all the indicators. I've studied the most popular indicators and how they operate. And I've come to the conclusion that they're all lagging behind. But now, you can use it. If you're just starting in forex trading, you can use something like moving averages to determine your market trends. But now, how will you even be using it to determine your market trends when you can learn how to do? There's a video on this channel that teaches you how to determine the market trend. How can you determine the market trend and stuff like that? So they teach you the raw aspect of forex trading without you using indicators and stuff like that. So yes, you can use indicators as a beginner to determine some few things in forex trading like the market trend, but you should never use indicator to predict, or you should never base your trading decision to either buy and sell solely on an indicator, because they all lagging behind. All right, then let's go to the next question. Say, how can a forex trader learn and stay consistently profitable in the market? All right, how can the forex trader learn? On this channel, talking about the learning aspect, I've covered that already. I have an ongoing course. I think we're already on, video number 25 or something. An ongoing course from A to Z. It has everything. You have everything in forex trading. Or even if you go through that course and you still want somebody to mentor you, somebody to take your hand from A to Z, from beginner to pro, then I'm still there. You can still contact me and I'll be able to. Very soon, my website will be up. My website will be up with a strategized structure where people can follow. So with things that are talking about the learning aspect of it, it has already been covered. But now when you learn what will enable you to be consistently profitable, remember in forex trading, there's a difference between a professional forex trader and a consistently profitable forex trader. So there's a difference between a profitable forex trader and a professional forex trader. Education will make you a professional forex trader, but a skill and long-term experience will make you a profitable forex trader. You might be a professional forex trader, but yet you are not a profitable forex trader. You might be a professional forex trader for years upon years, but yet you are not a profitable forex trader. On this channel, I teach you how to be a professional forex trader, then how to be now a profitable forex trader for the rest of your life. So you don't confuse those two differences. Professional forex trader, professionalism comes with experience. Professionalism just comes with any knowledge that you want to see in forex, all right? So professionalism comes with education, all right? Professionalism comes with education, while profitability comes with experience. You understand? Professionalism comes with education, while profitability comes with experience. So you can't be profitable if you are not experienced in forex, if you don't know what you are doing, all right? So let's go to the next question. This person said, is it possible to mentor or teach me how to trade since I'm in Botswana? This is YouTube. And I think if I go through my analytics, you can see if I'm scrolling through my analytics, you see I have like viewers from all over the world. Because even countries that don't speak English, there's what they call subtitles. They can translate my videos. They translate my videos into their language. So no matter where you are, through my channel, or even through my channel and through things I offer on my channel, you can still learn how to be a profitable forex trader. You can learn not only to be a professional forex trader, but to be a profitable forex trader. Let's go to the next question. You need to round up, guys. You need to round up. Let's go to the next question. You say, how long did it take you to be a profitable forex trader. For me, it took about 3.5 years, all right? Because I started at around 2015 to really be serious. I knew about forex trading around 2013, 2014, but I started really taking it serious in 2015, but I only became profitable. I only started making money consistently. I always stopped blowing accounts and start making money consistently by the beginning of 2019. So it took me about 3.5 years for me to really figure out what was forex trading, for me to really figure out the knuckles in forex trading and start making money consistently. So for now, I can boast and say when it comes to forex trading, I'm an authority. I'm an authority when it comes to forex trading. All right. So for me, it took 3.5 years. Now to gain a skill, if I can use 3.5 years to gain a skill, that will help me for the rest of my life, then I don't care. All right, so the time frame is not even the important. For you it can be less, for you it can be less, because for me, where I was, there was nobody who have ever traded forex before. So I was jumping, I was fishing out myself, I was figuring out everything by myself. That is why I have the experience I have today, because I learned the hard way. All right, so for me it took 3.5 years, but for you it might be shorter and it might be longer. So if you were asked, this one is from Saint Cooper, they say, if you were asked to help forex trading beginners with starting capital, will you help them? Just it's the same thing I explained earlier. If I teach you, if I give you fish, then I'll live to give you fish for the rest of your life. What I'll prefer to do will be to teach you how to trade. If you know how to trade, No matter how the account you start, you can through compounding that I will still teach you. You can grow that account to millions. All right. So the most important thing is for me teaching you how to fish, not giving you fish. So let's take the last four questions. They say, are you willing to take a student and mentor? I'm always open to mentor people. All right. Based on my schedule, I'm always open to enter I'm always open to mentor people. I know how to contact me. You can follow the spec on the channel to be able to choose the membership option where you can get to me one on one. Or when my website will be up, obviously I'll let you guys know. There'll be a link on the video description where you can get to my website, get to me one on one, and I'll be able to mentor you. Then this one say, let me just say, do you offer lessons on forex trading or business? Yes, it's the same thing. I've already answered that question. Yes, my channel is all about forex trading, business, and crypto. So you can get a lot of free information on my channel. But if that is not enough for you and you still want somebody to mentor you or to hold your hand along the journey, then you can still contact me. All right, then let's see. What do you understand about market makers? I have already answered this question. In forex trading, we have two types of forex brokers. You have ECN forex brokers and you have market makers. ECN stands for electronic communication network, while market makers is self-explanatory. So for market makers, they produce their own quote. All right, those quotes you are seeing on your screen, they take the quotes from the liquidity providers. Then they add their own spread on those quotes before they give you. So they have the ability to manipulate the market. But for ECN brokers, electronic communication network brokers, the ones I'll advise you to use, when you place your trade, either buy or sell, they don't hedge your trade, they don't trade against you. They send your trade directly to the interbanking system. All right. So that is the kind of broker that want you to keep winning, because the more you keep winning, the more you'll be trading with bigger sizes, with bigger lot sizes. And the bigger lot sizes you'll be trading, the more you'll be paying them a commission. So it's a win-win situation. And that is the best forex broker I advise you to go. Stay away from market makers. Then a robot, let's go to the next question. So robot or forex sinners or trade alone? All right, because now when I see people just starting in forex trading, they already start asking me if I can give them a robot, or start asking me if I can give them signal. If you are just starting in forex trading, those are the things that will finish all your life savings, even including borrowed money. All right, signals and robot and robotic trading. If you don't know how to do, if you don't know what you are doing, if you are just starting in forex trading, forget about asking signals from people. Forget about trading robot. Because even if you take a trading robot from someone, that person has programmed his or her trading strategy on that robot. You taking that robot and using it, you don't even know the program behind that robot. If you have been watching my live video, you see on almost all my live videos, I have more than 8 personal robots that I've built myself. But I developed the robot myself with my own strategy behind that algorithm. All right, so I know how the robot works. I know how to manage it. That is why I can even use a robot. So when you are just starting, learn raw trading, learn raw forex trading, learn price action, learn demand and supply level, learn buying and selling pressure, learn all those things that I've been able to teach on this channel. I think it is almost about 40 videos only about that. So that is what you're supposed to learn. When you know how to trade that, you see that forex robots are not even useful, or signals are not even useful. All right, so start with the raw trading. Forget about signals and forget about robot. There is no way you ever make money in forex trading taking signals from someone. There's no way you ever make money in forex trading buying a robot from someone. So I'm just telling you guys out of experience. I've bought all those things, I've used all those things so that you won't fall in the same trap. So I've already suffered that aspect of trading for you, so you shouldn't make the same mistake. Then what is the best time frame a beginner can stick to? All right, so the best time frame you can use as a beginner is H4, the 4-hour time frame, because it gives you a lot of time to see the bigger view of the market. Although when you are starting, learn how all the time frame works, because in forex trading you have three types of traders. You have a scalper, you have a day trader, and you have a swing trader. If you are somebody who focus on lower time frames, like maybe 5-minute time frame, 1-minute time, you are a scalper. Going out to maybe 1-hour time frame, 4-hour time frame, you are a day trader. And then going to daily time frame, weekly time frame, monthly time frame, you are a swing trader. So you see, you have to learn all those time frames. You know how it works, so that even if you want to do scalping for that day, you can go on a bigger time frame to see a bigger picture, to have a bigger picture of the market, how the currencies are moving. Then you step down to a lower time frame to take your decisions. So have an idea of how all the different time frames work. But as a beginner, you should take more of your trade on H4, on the 4-hour time frame, because the levels can easily be determined. You can easily see what we call major and minor support and resistance level and stuff like that. But have an idea of all the time frames and be able to use all the time frames. Then I think with that being said, the questions are still too many, but those are the most important ones I was able to filter. On the next video, on the same next week, the same day, I'll still come up with another episode. So if you want me to come up with more episode of question and answers, where I answer questions like this, if you gain something from this video and you want me to come up with more episode of question and answers like this, then please leave a like on this video and also click the red subscribe button below to subscribe to the channel. By doing so, I'll know you guys need more of this and I'll be able to come up with more of these pools. I'll put it on Instagram, people will come up with their questions and I'll be able to answer it on this channel. So with that being said, if you've gained something from the video, don't forget, you know what to do, hit that subscribe button below. Hit that red subscribe button to subscribe to the channel. If you want the best forex broker that you can use for your forex trading, there's a link below. Go on that link and choose the best forex broker so that you can be able to use in trading. And you also, if you want to join a Telegram channel, a Telegram community of forex traders that share ideas on a daily basis, my Telegram channel is also on the video description. That is the only Telegram channel I have. Any other one is a scam. So be very careful, don't be desperate, and be safe. So make sure you join that. Stay profitable, stay happy, and I will see you guys on another video. Peace.